Your butt is sitting back in the chair on its own.
Yeah, it's because it's pushed up.
She got a butt. She got a butt. Hey.
Could be a song. She got a butt.
She got, she baby got a butt.
Okay, welcome back to the Epicurean
and the Herbalist. We're here. Once
we
again.
Are here.
We are here.
Another week has passed.
Yes.
We have made it through.
Well, we're making progress. Come on now. Be happy about this.
Well, the topics that we are on today, we definitely need to talk about stress.
We're still talking about the immunity system.
And how stress impacts the immunity system.
Yeah. We're talking about stress.
Yeah.
Getting a good night's sleep.
Which is important. Well-balanced diet.
Yeah, eating foods with probiotics. Yeah.
Probiotics.
So, yeah. So we're going to discuss all of that today.
I'm chipper.
Yes, I'm chipper.
Okay, so anywho, then let's get into stress. Like, life can throw us some punches.
A lot. She had a few this morning, so that's what happens when you're ready.
And you wake up and you feel like, oh, today is the day. Like, you're going to tackle all these things. You have these lists in your head.
Yeah.
And you're like, I'm ready. And then as you're trying to make it through your list, just things come out of left field. And you're like, I didn't anticipate that. Which further causes stress and anxiety.
Yeah. The list are made to be broken. Let's realize that.
Not my word. And from a person like me that has like anxiety and I'm a list person and I try to like make it through those things, it throws like my whole day off. So ways to deal with stress.
I have one. Since you said she's a list person.
Yeah.
If I have a list, and this is from being a mother and a grandmother in years of that, you understand lists are wonderful. But you know what you need to do with that list? Be flexible. Move it, child. You know, if something can be done today, move it out the way. It can be done later.
You know, if something can be done today, move it out the way.
Oh, come on. Be a cop.
We in the wrong business.
Yes, we are. But you know, you have to be flexible. Life brings on so many challenges. You have to be able to just look at it and laugh. You know what? Hey, W didn't get me down today.
Yeah.
Because that's what happens. There are so many things. The enemy throws things at our mind, our body. We're barraged with junk. That's stress. Looking at a bill. Oh, trying to figure out how I'm going to pay the bill. Yeah. Looking at life. COVID, something is coming in all the time. We get it 24/7. So let's talk about that though. What can you do? I know what I do. I turn off the news, everybody. Oh.
Stress. For stress, what do I do?
I turn off the news.
Typically eat. No. That's what we're not doing this year. Stress things. What I do really at nighttime, which helps me, is like, I'm not a good meditation person. Mm-hmm. Like, my mind never turns off completely. So sound bowls, I am super into.
Yes.
Been around for thousands of years. And you can literally go on YouTube and like pick a sound bowl meditation for whatever is going on. For stress, sometimes I do it for like internal healing. All of those frequencies kind of like speak to you.
Yes.
And to your body. So I'm a firm believer on that. It works better for me than like guided meditation with words. I feel like my mind goes all over the place. It's like me when I'm in church. I can't ever really get the lesson because I'm looking at like the lady playing the tambourine. Like, why is she playing the song in the middle of the song? Somebody dancing, so if those types of things are hard for me to grasp. So I found that it's easier for me to listen to something with like overlapping vibrations, all of those things that kind of help me calm down at the end of my day and go to sleep.
Right.
Because that's another problem, is not getting adequate rest.
Now that one I do have a problem with.
I know, you never like to sleep.
I don't, and it's so unnerving because I understand you have to get that foundation in.
Yeah.
I usually have maybe 4 hours of solid sleep a night, and then after that, the mind won't shut off. But what I do use is a lot of herbal teas.
That's good too.
Yeah, teas, and I love lavender.
Oh yeah.
Lavender is wonderful. You know, I use it in aromatherapy.
I use it in the kids' bath to knock them out at night.
And I use it in hydrosols. So I spray my pillows, and then I'll put it also in my diffuser.
Okay.
You know, and for me, there's always calculation for the next day. And for me, that kind of takes me away. And then also, I like to listen to Soul Streams. It's a lot of believers' beliefs. For me, I like that foundational thing where they can, it gives me the word and it's telling me to be calm and take my back to sleep.
Right.
In a nice way.
Right.
So that works for me. And, you know, it's better than me counting sheep. It gets to be very boring, you know. So the sheep, I start looking at the size of the sheep. What's that? What are you doing? It gets to be hilarious. So, you know what?
Makes sense.
You can start picking out sheep. It's crazy. So, but for the lavender, I can close my eyes. I can relax. And I noticed that you wear the mask. And I always talk about that. And my grandbaby, they wear a little mask.
Oh, eye mask is everything. And so, yeah, I have little Journey Belle. Yes. She's like the complete diva. And she has to sleep with the eye mask on. So does her teddy bear. It's really cute.
It's cute. I can't do that. I need to see just in case.
That's a good way to help with stress. And lowering your stress also helps your immunity system, which goes hand in hand there. So it's a quick, you know, reminder to ourselves to find ways to disconnect. And whatever your way is, it could be walking in nature. It could be reading a book at the end of the night. It could be so many things. I think there's not like a one size fits all. Same with herbs. It's not a one size fits all. It's like, find what works with your body and what works for your lifestyle. Because no two is the same.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
I agree.
I think that's good. Let's get into probiotics.
Oh, there's probiotics. There's prebiotics.
There's so many biotics.
And yes, let me tell you, from everything from mushrooms to kombucha, fermented foods.
I love kombucha. So okay. I'm a firm believer in kombucha. I drink maybe like a half a cup each morning. First thing in the morning on an empty stomach. And for me, it's really good with dealing with gut health, free radicals, anti-inflammatory. I got little tweaks done, and we'll get into that. So I've been doing a lot of anti-inflammatory things. There's a million different flavors or versions of it, but that is my probiotic. I like taking that better than like a yogurt or a pill. I think that live fermentation for me is better. I don't like to take dead things. So in my mind, I kind of think like when I'm taking a probiotic in a pill form, I can't correlate that it's still living. So I like to use that, and it's really good. Great antioxidants. You know, we want to keep it tight and right. So I'm a firm believer in kombucha. And if it's done right, and don't go like try to make your own kombucha because it could go wrong. So that's another thing. I love kombucha. That's my go-to probiotic.
I'm a kombucha person too at times, but I prefer a lot of fermented foods like kimchi, the organic raw
sauerkraut.
I love kefir, and the vegan kefir. I'll use that, the kefir. It's just like, you know, a fermented milk. And then I also love all of the mushrooms. Mushrooms are excellent. So, you know,
they can take you on a ride.
Yeah, you can. Yes, they can. I'm not using any funny ones. Okay, no magic mushrooms in here. If I was, I would be blue. But anyway, that's a different topic too. But I do love the fermented foods. I try to incorporate them into our meals. So, you know, you can get the spicy kimchi. You can get just the regular sauerkraut, the raw organic, and you can put that into your foods. And it's wonderful. Serve it up in a meal, and nobody is missing anything. But yet, still, they're getting the benefit. There's a lot of different ways to use it.
Yeah,
those are my go-tos.
And all of this works together in a big system, right?
With a well-balanced diet.
Yes. So you can't like be all over the place. You can't have McDonald's and then turn around and then we can put some kimchi on your Big Mac.
Yes.
It doesn't really work like that.
Yeah.
And so I think a lot of times that we get into places where it's like we want to fix things about ourselves, but we don't want to go the full the full distance. And so one helps the other. So you have to kind of start making just little tweaks and things to help the overall system. Because what I've realized is when we make, and I used to be really bad at this, to say, I'm going on this diet, right? And I'm going to do A, B, and C. And then when I get on it, it's so restrictive that I fail all the time.
Right.
And it's really less about like a diet and more about a lifestyle.
Yes.
Of saying, I'm going to make small tweaks to my day each day, whether it be drinking, you know, a probiotic in the morning, having something fermented at night. It's like the little small things that add up to the big win,
right?
That makes it successful.
Yes,
I think.
Oh, I think you're on the right track. And again, I would just end with the fact that your immunity is everything. It's your protection.
It is.
So everything that we went over in the last video, from drinking plenty of fluids, exercising regularly, stress, the good night's sleep, probiotics, and
sound
eating well balanced, and sound bowl. Definitely the sound bowls. She's a sound bowl girl. Listen to that. So with all of these things, I would add in to make sure that you're doing something that's gonna get a good habit with maybe a good herbal tea. We recommend echinacea.
Oh, echinacea tea is good.
It's an excellent tea to have on a daily basis. Remember, if you're on it for 6 days, get off the 4 day. Allow your own immune system to build up its own.
Super strength. Important,
but yes, super you important. Can't stay on these things forever now.
Yeah,
and nothing's forever. So it's
nothing.
Nothing. Except for our Heavenly Father. But other than that, we got a date. So in the meantime, we do this. We take what we need to take. We get off. We give our bodies a chance to respond and get back into the game. We all need a break. But when you're drinking this tea, is one of the best things that you can do because it is going to boost your immune system.
Yeah.
And that's my word.
Well, you heard Mama, and she knows best.
Did you hear that? Can I say it again?
That was it.
I'll say it. Mama knows best.
We'll see you next time. Cheers to
Grant the Herbal Triage.